We wanted to create a MOOC based on experience, reflection, and based around you. Which teaching and learning model have we used to imagine and produce the scenario or the session plan? Which training model have you just experienced? It is the experiential learning cycle from Kolb. This model can be used to imagine, create a whole training session over a period of time or just 1 or 3 hour lessons. The model takes for granted that learning happens by action, by reflection, centered around the learner, and that there is a link between the learner's experience and how they use this learning. Kolb gets its inspiration from 4 philosophers and researchers. Dewey, Lindemann, Knowles, and Lewin, whose works were based around experience, adult education, and the retroactive process. They are the people who at the beginning of the 20th century defined experiencing as an important contribution to the learning process. The concept of experiential learning appeared for the first time in 1969 with Rogers. As for experiential learning, Kolb offers this definition: a process by which knowledge emerges from transforming experience. Whilst observing the learners, he studied the way they were learning. He noticed that everyone engaged in the learning process goes through a 4-phase cycle. Through discovery and experiencing, then observing of this experience, followed by integrating of new skills as a result of the experience, and lastly, embedding these new skills which allows the learner to experiment and learn again. Kolb has been the pioneer in designing the experiential learning model. When we talk about experience, it is not solely connected to technical or scientific experiences, but can be connected to a whole set of different activities, including role plays, written work, bibliography research, for example. This model lends itself to motivating the learners on several levels. For example, the first phase elicits interest from the learner. The second phase gives ways of understanding the experience, the takes, the debate. It also gives the learner the confidence and the ability to reflect and then take a critical stand on the experience. The third phase responds to the need of generalizing, as well as understanding the context which surrounds us, not just for this experience, but also for those in the future. Therefore, the 4th phase allows the learner to consolidate all the concepts and skills acquired hitherto. The learner can test his own personal effectiveness. The learner will also be able to set his own objectives, based on the previous learning and practice, with a view to reusing his knowledge in future situations. In this model, each phase is important. However, it has been shown that what matters is not the order of the aforementioned phases, but their essence. Therefore, the experiential learning cannot be reduced to just experience itself. It is the combination of the 3 following phases, experience, reflection, and conclusion, which constitutes the process of experiential learning. Following these studies, Kolb steers towards a study of different learning styles related to the cycle. As a result, Kolb recognizes that there are 4 main learning styles which match the 4 phases of the cycle. May I just say here that in this video we will not speak about different learning styles, but the use of such a model to prepare a lesson or a training session. In the MOOC, we wanted to help you discover a teaching approach, to reflect upon it, and then to bring you the theory behind this concept with a view to putting into action your discoveries, thoughts, and ideas, and to give you the tools to experiment your own scenario. This is why we have chosen this model. The learner is at the core of the learning process, notably regarding the following question. What the learner be able to do not only by the end of the cycle, but also by the end of each phase? Consequently, these phases allow us to identify the specific learning outcomes which will enable us to achieve the skills through practical applications. In order to understand how the learner can develop these skills, we can use the Bloom's taxonomy revisited by Anderson and Crathwell. This new taxonomy is key, as it allows us to meet the skills from all levels in Bloom's taxonomy pyramid, along with the key concepts from the knowledge dimension. This taxonomy, together with the Kolb cycle, produces a deeper level of understanding as it goes further by reaching the metacognitive dimension. In this way of using the model and recognizing the learning outcomes needed, we are, in turn, able to think about the teaching and learning methods for each of the phases. Teaching and learning, in itself, relies heavily upon the method of experiential learning. Experiential learning calls upon the creation of a series of varied activities based on experience, observation, and conceptualization. It is these varied activities which effectively make the learner the authors of his own experiences and his own learning. The active methods of teaching and learning are based on a teaching approach geared towards the learner rather than the content, as well as real-life situation which will affect the concepts studied. For example, for the concrete experience, you can have brainstorming session, role-play, debate, case study, experiment, bibliography research. For the reflective observation, you can have small group discussion, active questioning, oral presentation. For the abstract conceptualization, you can have the creation of conceptual card, reading and watching theoretical materials. And for the active experimentation, you can have group work, group experimentation, role play, series game, peer-to-peer observation, etc. As a result, we can make the connection between Kolb's experiential learning cycle and the active teaching and learning methods. The integration and ultimately the success of these methods required a well-formed scenario. Scenario which then becomes possible to create thanks to the experiential learning cycle model. There were since other learning cycles, such as the 5 e-learning cycle. They are all based on the same concept. Therefore, we see the importance of creating a scenario based on the following points: the experiential learning model, the learning outcomes, and the use of the active teaching and learning methods. Let's not forget the evaluation stage, the importance of combining the evaluation with the teaching and learning objectives and methods. I hope that you will find this model useful. There is, however, no right or wrong approach, but it is one which will give you the reassurance and satisfaction with whatever you want to achieve.